So on track cars for the Curbstone GT Sports Club, getting their first of two track sessions. The GT1 Sports Club bringing owners of the cars to the circuit, and a perfect opportunity for the owners to exploit cars that are totally designed for the circuit. The Dittamaso you are looking at here, the car new to Sports Club ranks, and a great shape because it sort of combines the heritage of Dittamaso with modern technology, and that car blasting its way up towards turn four. Not to respond to this because of the amazing sound that the cars make, but the car blasting down towards turn 10. Dittamaso, the Argentine firm, founded back in 1959, and although perhaps it's a name that's dropped off the radar a little bit, great to have modern cars and a fascinating shape that this is. So the Dittamaso heads up the hill. Alejandro Dittamaso, who created the company, and the idea was to have Italian styling, and the Dittamaso being brought back with the P72, and then the P70 also brought into the ranks now. The Pagani on track, and gives us, as it accelerates up the hill, the perfect chance to listen to one of the best sounding cars. It will sing its way around the circuit, the Pagani. Let's just wallow for a lap or so.
Apollo, the AE Apollo, built with Japanese and German engineering, built in China. Quite a spectacular looking vehicle. As we switch our attention to rather garish coloured Pagani, which I believe was given to its new owner this morning. In the GT1 Sports Club paddock, which sits at the very centre of the paddock here in Barcelona. And therefore, possibly the first opportunity for the new owner to experience what this incredible vehicle is capable of. Thank you. we do have a little trip to the gravel, unfortunately, down at turn five with one of our cars, and therefore the red flags have been shown to allow vehicles on track to recover one of our Paganis, which is a real shame. Didn't look like too much damage was done to what is a over €1 million vehicle. Opportunity to look very close up to these absolutely incredible machines. Full carbon fiber colours. Nürburgring's Nordschleife sticker on the windscreen. I don't really fancy taking one of those around there. The comforts of a gravel trap and barriers far away, certainly. Very extra special situation for these owners, these drivers, to have the chance not only to drive these vehicles on a closed circuit under these controlled conditions from SRO, but also precursor to the final Endurance Cup round on track in front of a huge crowd. And there's always been over the weekend a big gathering of fans taking photos of these vehicles in the paddock. I didn't count how many Paganis we've got here, but I think it's nigh on 10. Do the maths. The Pagani Zonda R here. This particular Pagani we're looking at is the Huara, I believe. We had a quick, very brief look at the Apollo. We've had other vehicles part of the GT1 Sports Club over the opportunities that they have run in conjunction with Curbstone events, which I can see right in the center of shot. Curbstone gathering these vehicles and offering up the opportunities for these vehicles to be used on some of the best racetracks in the world. We've seen Brabham bring their car. We've seen the Isetto Franceschi, which was kind of a replica, effectively, to the Le Mans car that they're going to be participating with next year in the World Endurance Championship. And they built a track version of that for customers, which was in the paddock. I can't remember which one that was. Maybe it was in Spa. We've had McLaren Sennas. McMurty, I think, also was going to show at Spa-Francorchamps. And now, in this paddock, the Apollo AE. Apollo moving away from combustion engines to electric vehicles, trying to become the first all-electric hypercar.
Thank you.